When Jesus walked in the room, heads turned, hearts burned, and souls yearned for the glory of God. And their minds scrambled and rambled, saying, I want what he's got. And that very thought inspired hope and yet inspired conflict, because he was the Messiah that they needed. But they wanted something different, because this son of a virgin and friend of sinners was not the Savior they expected. You see, it's indisputable. Our God is unconventional.
When the Assemblies of God was started, 300 followers said, we commit ourselves and the movement to him for the greatest evangelism the world has ever seen. Now is the time to not give up. Now is the time to not be silent. Now is the time to not retreat. Jesus never said it would be safe, and I'm looking for a generation to get behind me because the gospel must be spread. This is a moment where you and I have to think unconventionally, to act unconventionally, to speak unconventionally, and to dream unconventionally, because God is looking for you to rise up and change the entire globe.
Columbus is a city named after the man who had the unconventional idea that the world isn't flat. And what do you say we test that out and circumnavigate the globe of our own expectations, to sail beyond the borders of our preconceived limitations, because it may just be time to go further than what's ever been explored, time to push past what has ever been known, time to dream, to speak, to act in a new way, because it's time to redefine what has ever been possible. Church, it's time to become unconventional.